Although being the First Lady of the United States is a highly visible role, the title itself is strictly ceremonial. What a woman chooses to do with that time is up to her. Today, we're going to talk about famous former First Lady Michelle Obama, how she made it to the White House, and all the great things she's doing now, many which you probably don't even know about just yet. But before we get started, make sure to click on the subscribe button and turn on your notifications for more videos from The Taco. Let's get started. At the 2016 Democratic Convention, Michelle Obama was asked if she would consider running for a government position. She responded, "I am not running for anything. My passion is not politics." Michelle Obama made it clear she is not interested in holding office, but rather making serious social change. Let's take a look at how she set herself upon this noble pursuit. Long before she would acquire the last name Obama, Michelle LaVon Robinson was growing up in a surprisingly conventional household. Her father, Frazier Robinson III, worked at the city water plant, and her mother, Marion Shields Robinson, stayed home until Michelle was in high school. The Robinson family was a close-knit one, and Michelle recalls many happy times spent playing board games or reading with one another. She was close to her brother Craig, who was only 21 months her senior, and the two siblings were occasionally mistaken for twins. But this idyllic family was not without their share of hardships. Michelle's father suffered from multiple sclerosis, a condition which severely affected his mobility. It was difficult for his children to watch him struggle, and Michelle recalled watching him use two canes to walk to work every day. Despite dealing with severe mobility issues, Frazier would never miss the chance to participate in elections, and Michelle learned to never take her health or her right to vote for granted. Education was highly praised in the Robinson family, and both Michelle and her brother Craig soon found themselves skipping second grade. Michelle attended the prestigious Whitney Young High School, which required a daily commute lasting 3 hours. Not only was the journey daunting, but Michelle often found herself frustrated by the dismissive attitudes of her classmates. She frequently felt slighted and left out because of her gender, and it wasn't unusual for her peers to ask for her brother's opinion and not hers. But rather than be cowed by this negativity, Michelle used it as inspiration to push herself to her limits. She maintained her place on the honor roll and graduated salutatorian of her class. Despite her academic accomplishments, her college counselor once told her she was not Princeton material. Her teachers told her that she was setting her sights too high. But Michelle was not dissuaded and followed her brother Craig to Princeton University. Once she arrived, she was admittedly overwhelmed by a place she would later describe as extremely white and male. According to Michelle, she grew up feeling like a representative of her humble neighborhood, but at college, she felt like she was representing her entire race. This made her treat each quiz or class project with the utmost seriousness. And it wasn't just her imagination. Her first roommate's mother was so appalled by her daughter sharing a room with a black woman that she insisted the school change her room assignment. Michelle Robinson majored in sociology and earned a minor in African American studies, graduating cum laude in 1985. But she wasn't done with her education, actually very far from it. She would later remark that education gave her opportunities beyond what she ever imagined, and she went on to earn her Juris Doctor from Harvard Law School. While there, she worked for the Harvard Legal Aid Bureau, which helped low-income tenants with housing cases. After graduation, Michelle was focused on her career and claimed she had no time in her life for a romantic relationship, which is pretty much the optimal mindset for guaranteeing you'll soon be falling head over heels for someone. While working at the law firm Sidley Austin LLP, she soon found herself mentoring a charismatic new hire named Barack Obama. She soon found herself impressed by this confident associate, but resisted when he first asked her out. She thought dating her mentee and one of the few other black people at the firm would be tacky. But soon, Michelle and Barack were inseparable. When the topic of marriage came up, they both looked at the institution a bit differently. According to Michelle's memoir, Becoming, Barack saw marriage as the loving alignment of two people who could live parallel lives, but without forgoing any independent dreams or ambitions. But Michelle believed marriage was more like a full-on merger, a reconfiguring of two lives into one, with the well-being of a family taking precedence over any one agenda or goal. Despite these differences, the two soon found themselves walking down the aisle and foregoing a life together that was a combination of both their ideals. At times, they've both made sacrifices for the sake of their family, and they both support each other's careers. There are many things to admire about the marriage between the Obamas, and Michelle is often painted as the dutifully supportive spouse, so it might might surprise you to know that Michelle Obama was strongly opposed to him entering the realm of politics, at least at first. She had always been a very private person, and the idea of opening her family up to such intense scrutiny was daunting, and their small family was experiencing some turmoil, as the two yearned to have children, but found themselves struggling. After trying for so long to get pregnant, Michelle had a miscarriage, an event which she claims left her feeling failed and broken. In desperation, the two turned to in vitro fertilization, or IVF. This led to the births of their daughters Malia Ann and Natasha. Although Michelle was overjoyed, she now had to add motherhood to her already overflowing list of responsibilities. While it may seem strange to imagine a time when Michelle Obama didn't want to be First Lady at all, let's consider her career up until that point. She had overcome incredible odds to obtain an impressive educational resume and went on to become the executive director for the Chicago Office of Public Allies. This nonprofit organization encouraged young people to work on social issues, and Michelle claimed this position made her feel happy and fulfilled. Then she served as the Associate Dean of Student Services at the University of Chicago, where she dedicated her time to helping students and developing a community service center. Eventually, she found herself working for the University of Chicago Hospitals in the Community and External Affairs Department. But when her husband began his campaign for presidency, she was forced to cut back on her hours. Later, Michelle Obama would admit that when her husband began his bid for presidency, she followed along somewhat reluctantly and somewhat unsure, but she decided that no matter what happened, she would make sure some good came out of the experience. For her support during his campaign, she negotiated with her husband and got him to agree to quit smoking, which both parties agreed was a fair exchange. On the campaign trail, she was often asked what type of First Lady she would be and answered, "I won't know until I get there." Historically, the title of First Lady is often hard to define and has no real official duties. In general, these women are expected to dress appropriately, stand smiling at the president's side, and champion uncontroversial social causes in their spare time. But as you've probably noticed by now, Michelle Obama has never been one to stand idly by. Almost immediately, she began using her position to support programs which had always been important to her, and she stated that one of her goals was to make the White House feel more accessible to the average person. Former First Ladies Hillary Clinton and Laura Bush had instructed the White House to use organic food, but Michelle took this a step further. She planted the White House kitchen garden, which was the first of its time since the days of Eleanor Roosevelt. This organic garden also benefited from the beehive she had installed on the South Lawn. In many ways, Michelle Obama played the part of the traditional First Lady by showing up to homeless shelters and soup kitchens to volunteer, but she was also determined to champion her own causes, and her organic garden was just the start of her mission to fight back against the obesity epidemic. Although good eating habits and exercise are simply enough in theory, there are reasons why obesity is a serious health issue in the United States. She started the Let's Move initiative, which focuses on making sure children have access to good nutrition and encourages them to exercise regularly. It's rare that a First Lady manages to get any legislation passed, but Michelle accomplished this with her Healthy Hunger Free Kids Act. This provided a much-needed update to school nutrition standards, offering healthier options and making lunch more accessible to students. Another area in which Michelle enacted passionate change was education. Her Let Girls Learn and Reach Higher initiatives focused on improving access to education all over the world. There is no denying that Michelle revolutionized what it meant to be the First Lady, and that she was passionate about the causes she championed. While detractors were quick to criticize her for everything from her fashion choices to her initiatives, many people were impressed by her genuine nature and her tenacity. Michelle Obama has also supported LGBTQ rights and compares the gay rights movement with the civil rights movement. After her husband repealed Don't Ask, Don't Tell, Michelle included openly gay service members in her initiatives to assist military families. When the Defense of Marriage Act was repealed, Michelle and her daughter Malia stood outside the White House enjoying the rainbow lighting and celebrating with their fellow citizens. Making her enthusiasm all the more evident is what Michelle Obama has been doing now that she's no longer the First Lady of the United States. Michelle had always put her family first, and claims their bond is just as strong as ever, and that she's learned home is wherever she makes it. While she no longer has the White House as a platform for her causes, this doesn't mean she's forgotten about them. She's made appearances at many events advocating for female empowerment, including the Women's Foundation of Colorado's 30th anniversary event and the Pennsylvania Conference for Women. She's also working to encourage children's healthy eating habits, attending the Partnership for a Healthier America Summit in Washington, D.C. Michelle Obama has made it clear that these issues are no less important to her, and she's not going to give up the fight anytime soon. It's no surprise her courageous attitude has earned her so many admirers, or that many people wonder if she might someday run for office herself. But according to Michelle, she's looking forward to having more time for her family and has no interest in running for office. Recently, she released her memoir, Becoming, and according to Barnes & Noble, it had the biggest first-week sales of any book this year. Meanwhile, her husband, Barack Obama, is struggling to get his own memoir written. When discussing his writing difficulties, he advised fans to pick up his wife's book instead. While Michelle Obama took some time to adjust to being in the spotlight, her primary concern was always for her daughters. They spent most of their lives being the subject of intense scrutiny, with their every move being criticized. Now they are free to live relatively normal lives, and Michelle is overjoyed to report that both girls have managed to remain humble and down to earth. She takes joy in simple pleasures, such as rolling down the car windows, something her security force would never have allowed while her husband was president. For the first time in so long, Michelle feels as though she finally has a bit of breathing room. She and Barack Obama were even able to take a much-needed vacation together when he left office. If you're not much of a reader, you'll be glad to know that the Obamas have signed a deal with Netflix and will be producing content for the streaming service. The content won't be necessarily political, but will focus on their lives and areas of interest, including sports, lifestyle, and nutrition. It's clear that this amazing couple still has stories to tell and remain dedicated to promoting their shared values. While most of us consider Netflix to be a great way to binge our favorite shows, it's also a way to reach a massive international audience. If you're interested in keeping up with Michelle Obama, make sure to renew your subscription. What do you think about Michelle Obama? Do you think she deserves the praise and admiration she receives? Or do you find her less than impressive? Tell us what you think in the comments section, and then click on the subscribe button for the latest videos from The Taco. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time.